What is neuromodulation and how does it work? Neuromodulation works by using electrical stimulation to improve control of an existing part of the nervous system. Examples include spinal cord stimulation systems used for chronic pain management that block pain signals to the brain and gastric stimulation systems, which are used to block the signals of hunger. There are three different types of neuromodulation. Deep brain stimulation, DBS. Transcranial magnetic stimulation, TMS. Vagal nerve stimulation. Deep brain stimulation, DBS. This involves the placement of an electrode inside the brain with a wire running down the neck connected to a battery pack or pulse generator under the skin in the chest or abdomen. Currently used to treat Parkinson's disease, epilepsy, stroke and severe obsessive-compulsive disorders. Research is underway into its use to treat obesity, Tourette's syndrome, anorexia, addictions. Transcranial magnetic stimulation. When a strong, rapid current is passed through a stimulating coil, top, a rapidly changing magnetic field is produced, which induces current into the brain, bottom. Transcranial magnetic stimulation, TMS. This involves the application of a magnetic field to induce electrical currents into the brain. It is a non-invasive procedure. Currently used in several countries to treat depression, or to enhance cognitive functions such as attention, understanding, perception. Future applications may include treatment for severe migraines. There is significant interest in the development of TMS to enhance mood and cognitive skills such as problem solving and memory. TCMS requires hospital visits 5x40 minutes visits each week for up to 6 weeks. As a result of this ion flow, action potentials are triggered in neurons that are within the induced current field, along with a subsequent period of deactivation, presumably through prolonged IPSPs. Because normal ongoing brain activity is disrupted by this induced current, TMS provides a way for investigators to produce a transient and reversible period of brain disruption or virtual lesion. Thus, unlike other experimental techniques, for example, functional magnetic resonance imaging, fMRI, electroencephalography, EEG, /event-related potentials, ERPs, TMS can assess whether a given brain area is necessary for a given function rather than simply correlated with it. Vagus nerve stimulation, used to treat refractory epilepsy, produces a 40% reduction in fits in 40% of patients. Vagus nerve is both motor and sensory. Brain-machine interfaces, BMIs, devices that detect intent, typically intended movement, from brain activity, and translate it into an output action, such as control of a cursor on a screen or a robotic arm. Acquiring a neural signal that can be consciously controlled. Analyzing that signal to identify an intended motor output. And executing the intended action. Neuropharmaceuticals is an emerging field of therapy, applied through the use of devices combined with pharmaceuticals, particularly for cognition and emotional treatments. Examples include pumps for baclofen to treat spasticity or morphine for chronic pain. Intrathecal pump delivers medication to spinal fluid. There is no feedback loop.